So here's three of, only three of the platonic solids, the things you can make out of equilateral triangles. So here I've got a tetrahedron, four triangles, octahedron, eight triangles, and the icosahedron, 20 triangles. What's changing as you go from here to here to here is how many triangles there are around each corner, around each vertex. So the tetrahedron, right, has three triangles around a corner, and the octahedron has four, and the icosahedron has five. What comes next? Well, six triangles around a vertex. Do you get a platonic solid that has six triangles around a vertex?
No.
No, no, what do you get? So, all right, so here's six. So here's, you know, there's one triangle, two, three, four, five, six. So six triangles around a vertex, that tiles the plane, right? It goes on forever. Yeah, so it doesn't have any curve to it. So here's a way to think about it. So your triangle has 60 degrees at this corner. And so like 60 plus 60 plus 60, those are the three around here, that adds up to 180, which is, well, less than 360. So it sort of curves, it makes a cone shape. If you do this with the octahedron, you get 60, 60, 60, 60, which is what, 240? Still less than 360. With five of them, you've got 300. When you get to six, it adds up to 360, right? There's no lack of space. There's nothing missing, so it doesn't make a cone, it just makes it flat. Three, four, five, six. What happens if you try and put seven triangles on each vertex? Actually, you know what would be good? To try drawing it. I'm not gonna be able to make them all equilateral, but let's see how far we can get. So I've got to fit seven. So there's gonna be one here, and then I got fit three in here. So I gotta do this. And all right, so I fit seven around a vertex. So let's keep going. So I got two here already, so maybe I'll do that. That's five, six, seven, doop, 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 doop. Three, I gotta fit four in here. You can go for quite a while, actually, before you start running into trouble. One, two, three, four. You can speed this up, right? Okay, one, two, three, four. I got to fit three in here. You see, it starts getting difficult. There's too many of them. They don't really fit very nicely, and you start, oh, now I'm in real trouble. Look at this. One, two, three, four. I got to fit three in here. One, two, three, four in here. So, well, I mean, you can sort of see that, like, this is, well, try it at home, right? How far can you get drawing triangles with seven triangles on each vertex? What if I don't do it on paper? What if I do it with 3D printed stuff? Then you get this thing. So, all right, well, you can see there, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven triangles on each vertex. You know, the first thing you try and do is you try and lay it flat and it doesn't work. Like, you can make bits of it be kind of flat, and there's some give in the hinges, which sort of helps out. But then it bunches up somewhere else. Like, there's just no way to make it flat everywhere. It doesn't work. Right, what is going on, right? These are sort of like, they're closed around, they're sort of like spheres, right? Three, four, and five. Six is like the flat plane, sphere, plane. What is this thing trying to be? It doesn't look like it's some nice surface, it's just some horrible thing. We don't know what seven is. Maybe eight will be better. No, no, eight is not better, right? So this is eight equilateral triangles around each vertex. Like, I mean, you can count them, but like, it's this horribly crinkly, it's sort of like, it's like coral, or it's like lettuce. So these are positively curved things, which like a hill or a bowl, sort of curves towards you in all directions. Whereas like something that's flat, it's not curving at all, or like it can curve in one direction, but then the other direction is flat, right? Does that make sense? Like it's curved this way, but it has to be flat this way. You can't curve it in both directions. So one of the directions is flat, it's really just flat. And these are like, so it wants to be like a saddle. So you imagine my hand is a horse, right? And like the hand is like a horse and like your legs go either side of here. So what does that mean? Like sometimes it's curving towards you and sometimes it's curving away from you. So when you've got both of those, that's negative curvature or negative Gaussian curvature. So what are these things? These are sort of like, so these are models of hyperbolic space in a way. There's sort of too much of it. It doesn't want to fit in ordinary Euclidean space. It kind of wrinkles up and gets out of control. So these ones here, right? You run out of triangles, right? Once you're done with your 20 triangles on the icosahedron, you're done. This one I could have kept going forever, right? It's like I could just keep tiling this outwards and it would just, you know, fall off the table and go off around the world. This one, well, so again, I've only done like a little bit of it. It seems clear that I could keep going, right? I mean, I tried doing it over here with the pen, but it was sort of, you know, it's difficult. But it seems like you know, if you're allowed to sort of wrinkle them up out of the plane and like make this sort of wrinkly thing, then I could just keep going. Well, you kind of might run into trouble. So this is actually an open question. Nobody knows the answer. If you keep adding these things, how far can you go out into space without it crashing into itself? I mean, for this physical thing, there's a definite limit. And here's the argument, right? So as you sort of go out from like the central ring to the next ring to the next ring, like the amount of space you've got to play with is only going up like the cube of that distance, because you're making a sphere of possible places you could put triangles. But the number of triangles that you need actually goes up exponentially. So exponential versus cube, you lose, right? You if you go like a few layers out, you'll just get incredible numbers of triangles in a solid ball. Because these are made of plastic that has thickness, like each one of them has volume, and then like you just run out. But the problem that's open is like, suppose they're two-dimensional triangles, like connected at their hinges, like perfectly. How far can you go? Is there actually a limit? Because like two-dimensional triangles, you could stack like tons of them next to each other. And maybe you'd somehow be able to fit them in without crashing into each other. We don't think so, but there's no proof, like nobody knows. What's the farthest out you can go? I mean, it's sort of like really crinkly and nasty and not really smooth. And in the same sort of way, like the icosahedron is not that smooth. It's got these sort of corners. So what you can do to an icosahedron to make it smoother is like make a geodesic dome. So here's one way to do it, right? You take each triangle and you subdivide it into four, you know, like a triforce, cut it into four. And then you got these extra vertices in the middle of the edges, and you push them out to the sphere. And that makes a smoother polyhedron. It's no longer regular, but you know, it's a smoother thing that's more like a sphere. So I was like, all right, let's do that with this. It's got this crinkly thing. There's two, like here the angles add up to what, 360 plus 60 is 420. It's too many. There's like a lot of angle at each vertex. So if you do this sort of like geodesic dome thing with this thing, then it turns into this thing. So this is like, it's a little hard to see, but so I don't know if you can see this, right? So these four triangles, the three on the outside are slightly isosceles, and the one in the middle is actually equilateral. So this is subdivided, and then the extra vertices just squished around a little bit to make it a bit smoother. And then it's nicer, right? It's sort of, you can get quite large bits of it to be flat, although you can't get all of it to be flat. It always sort of bunches up somewhere, no matter how hard you try.
Looks like a doily.
Yeah, it's a hyperbolic doily. That's what it is. It really likes to be in sort of like saddles or crinkly stuff. Yeah, it's fun to play with.
On the short side, so long side is n, the short side is n minus one. So each rectangle is n times n minus one. There's three of them, so there's three lots of that, and then there's one in the middle.
Well, right, so, oh man, that's a really hard question. Okay, all right, here we go.